welcome to this special edition of Rajya Sabha Television Question Hour, where we get you important unstarred questions asked by the members of the Rajya Sabha and the answers given by the government. I'm Kriti Mishra, and joining me is my colleague, Vishal Dhaya.
Well, thank you, Kriti. And the first question is to the Ministry of Defence. And the question is from the member, Anubhav Mohanty, who goes on to ask the government whether the country's first indigenous combat fighter aircraft, Tejas, which was first approved in 1983, is not yet combat ready.
The government goes on to answer that the light combat aircraft Tejas has already achieved initial operational clearance in December 2013 for fighter version of aircraft, and 10 fighter version aircraft have been delivered to Indian Air Force. These aircraft are equipped with various combat equipment as envisaged for IOC version of the aircraft. Final operational clearance was initially planned by Aeronautical Development Agency for December 2012. However, the same has not yet been achieved by the ADA. Delays in attaining FOC have been mainly due to delay in finalization of air-to-air refueling contract, challenges faced in integration of air-to-air refueling probe and associated major hardware, structural modification and software, flight control, software modification and flight testing. The next question has been asked by members Neeraj Shekhar and Ravi Prakash Verma, and they have asked the Minister of Drinking Water and Sanitation the details of the states covered under National Water Quality Submission, which addresses the urgent need of providing clean drinking water to arsenic and fluoride affected habitations in the country.
Well, the ministry in its answer, Kriti, says that states like Andhra Pradesh, Assam, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Haryana, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Odisha, Punjab, Rajasthan, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal are considered under National Water Quality Submission to provide safe drinking water to arsenic or fluoride affected habitations. The next one is to the Ministry of Earth Sciences, and this is from the member Banda Prakash. He goes on to ask the government the details of the current mechanism being followed to predict rainfall and whether the ministry is considering to take any steps to devise an intelligent prediction expectation system with modern analytical tools by using local weather information for the prediction of rainfall.
The government has given a very elaborate answer, and the government goes on to say that the Indian Met Department issues three types of rainfall forecasts: seasonal forecast for the whole season, extended range forecast for 10 to 30 days, short medium range forecast for 10 days. These forecasts are prepared using dynamical prediction models. Under the National Monsoon Mission, MOES has been implemented to state-of-the-art dynamical prediction systems for short-range to medium, extended-range and seasonal forecasts. An improved suite of prediction models has already been implemented operationally at Indian Met Department for enhanced short-range weather forecasting through assimilation of all available Indian and global satellite data in real time. Since December 2016, Indian Met Department is using the Global Forecast System, or GFS, and unified model run at National Center for Medium Range Weather Forecast operationally every day to generate forecasts at 12 kilometers horizontal resolution in the short to medium range. There is also high resolution mesoscale model with 3 kilometers resolution to provide location specific forecast. The next question has been asked by member Amar Shankar Sable, and he has asked the Minister of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation whether it is a fact that recently the water storage level of 91 major reservoirs of the country has gone down.
Well, the ministry in its detailed answer says that the CWC, that's the Central Water Commission, monitors live storage status of 91 major reservoirs of the country on weekly basis and issues weekly bulletin on every Thursday. Now, as per reservoir storage bulletin dated 13th of December 2018, live storage available in these reservoirs is 92.387 billion cubic meters, which is 57% of total live storage capacity of these reservoirs. The live storage available in these reservoirs for the corresponding period of last year was 94.374 BCM, and the average of last 10 years live storage is 98.631 BCM. Thus, the live storage available in 91 reservoirs as per 13th December 2018 bulletin is 98% of the live storage of corresponding period of last year and 94% of storage of average of last 10 years. So now let's move on to the next question, and this one is from member Vandana Chavan, who goes on to ask the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change about the details of the changes in forest cover and dense forest cover over the last 3 years.
The government goes on to say that the Forest Survey of India, Dehradun, a subordinate organization under the ministry, carries out the assessment of forest cover of the country biannually, and the findings are published in India State of Forest Report. As per the latest report, ISFR 2017, the total forest and tree cover in the country is 8,2,088 square kilometers, which is 24.39% of the geographical area of the country. There is an increase of 8,021 square kilometers of total forest and tree cover compared to that of ISFR 2015. As per ISFR 2017, the total of very dense forest and moderately dense forest in the country is 4,06,476 square kilometers. Moving on to the next question, and this one has been asked by member AK Selvraj, and he has asked the Road Transport and Highways Minister whether it is a fact that during the last 4 years, government has added 38,000 kilometers to the national highway network to expand the total length to 1.29 lakh kilometers.
Well, the Road and Transport Ministry in its answer says that the total length of national highways has been enhanced from about 91,287 kilometers as on 31st of March 2014 to about 1,31,326 kilometers at present, in view of the declaration of about 39,040 kilometer length of state roads as new national highways, besides modification in existing national highway length on account of realignments, construction of bypasses, etc. The ministry also says that it has approved in principle declaration of about 53,031 kilometer length of state roads as new national highways, subject to outcome of their detailed project reports. Initiatives have also been taken up for preparation of these DPRs. Well, the next question and the last one for this segment of question hour is from K. Bhavananda Singh. He goes on to ask the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports about the status of recruitment of Vice Chancellors and Registrar of National Sports University and by when they would be joining the university. Also, he asked the ministry about the details of present facilities, officers and staff of the university.
The government says that the process of appointment of first Vice Chancellor and first Registrar in terms of the provisions of the National Sports University Act 2018 has been initiated and applications have been invited. They will join after the selection process is completed. Presently, Secretary, Department of Sports, Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports has been appointed as Interim Vice Chancellor, National Sports University, Imphal. At present, there are 11 teaching staff, one professor, one associate professor and 9 assistant professors engaged on loan and contract basis. On the non-teaching side, 26 persons for office work, security and housekeeping have been engaged through outsourcing agency in NSU.
So, well, Kriti, that was it in this segment of the Question Hour.
Prashnkal with our colleagues Arvind Singh and Akhilesh Suman on the other side. Stay tuned.